Well, here we go with part number 5 of the 58 GMC Resurrection. Now, you might notice the absence of a vlog, and that's because the logistical improbabilities of trying to do the vlog. I thought I would, you know, do a few shots at work and show you what's going on, but it's just not going to happen. And I pulled the first one because of other logistical improbabilities. So that's the end of that. This video is 18 minutes 57 seconds long. If I put a comment to response at the end, it's going to be like a half hour long, so I'm not going to make it a half hour long. I'll probably do that as a separate video, and that way I can just put more and more videos up, like our peak. Okay, on to this. Oh, you might notice the absence of that monitor, because I've been having all those problems. I decided to take this video card out, and I went with a Quadro, because I went on Box, who makes computers for 3D modeling, and their base level computer uses the Quadro K620. So I got one of those, put it in there, but my HDMI to VGA adapter, you can't put both plugs right next to each other. It's got to have some cable length to it. So I ordered one of those. When that gets together, then I'll use that separate monitor or other things. But this is all I get for now. And this is all you get for now. Ready? Go.
Creates. Ooh. Don't like that. Ha! Hate it when that happens. Might have to do our workaround on this. Half inch. Not enough room to do the workaround. Alright. Only one thing left. Notice I did not light my torch like that. Don't touch it! Okay. Crap bin. Now, rather than trying to undo these, pull all that out of there, I'm just going to undo this. I gotta do both sides anyway. Right side goes on the bottom, left side goes on the top. There's also, well, I guess they're the same. Never mind. And I'm going to pull this apart as well. Only because I want to lube all of these joints. And I want to wire wheel the pins and everything. For better braking application efficiency. Proper tool. She's stuck. And it still don't want to go. I'll leave it sit there for a while. Let it think about it. In the meantime, you wanted roosters? You got roosters. Some of you think I should have a ball peen hammer. Oh, don't tell me. That's not going to go through there. So I do have to take this all apart. Well, at least it's more convenient this way. Cleaning! more better. But why stop there? I didn't really need all that, but I was here. Now, the manual clearly states explicitly that you are to replace this cotter pin when you take this apart. Well, when you put it back together. So I see no point in trying to save it. And you're supposed to use the screwdriver made for this to get that out of there. Well, I just don't happen to have one of them. I do, however, happen to have this file. Now, files are very hard and very brittle, so you do stand a chance of breaking one if you attempt to do what I am about to do. But I really don't think there's a whole lot of torque on that, as we see here. There's something I'm going to show you after I take this apart. Time to pull the other side, which you're not going to see. So underneath the plug, you have the outer, the inner, the spring, and then the, what do you want to call that thing for aligning the spring? But that's not what I wanted to show you.
This is what I wanted to show you. Straightening.
So gravity is going to show me where the direction of the curve is. Like that. And then if I take a straight edge, and I set on here, it's going to show me that there is no spot on here that is truly straight. Hey, what do you know? Pipe wrench marks. So I have almost straight. I don't have almost straight. Okay, so I kind of sort of got almost straight. So using the nearly impossible to see orange highlighter, I do have some, a wee bit of straight section, which is from here to here. Okay, well the file will work. So I'm gonna make me a nice scrape along the top to know where my bow is. And then I'm straight from here here, so the largest part of my bend is from here to here. Where is the apex of my bend? So if I go to where it's equal distance by eye, I see that the point of impact with whatever it is they hit is right there. So in theory, if that was the point of impact, if you support equidistant from there and push down on it, that'll bring that section of it straight. However, when it hit there, it bowed the entire thing. There's a little strain 6 inches on the end, the straight section there, and then this is terribly bad. Now, you can take and put this in a vise like that. And then since this is the end with the most leverage, you could, in theory, clamp that right at the apex, pull out on this, and kind of straighten that. But what you'll end up doing is you'll put a sharp bend in here, which actually goes the opposite direction. So you're not doing yourself any favors by doing that. One thing I will do right now is I'll stick the center of the apex
or I'll stick the apex. Center the apex in the vise. Give it a good yar. And see what kind of flexing we get.
Why?
Yes, it does flex. And I wonder if that helped any at all. No. This part from here to the apex is straight. So all of my bending needs to be done with this part clamped and the rest of it that way. But what I should really do is put this in a press. So you see the curvature. So you see that space there, the amount of time it took me to set up this camera, I could have had this done back on a truck practically. So we squeeze. That worked wonderfully without bending it the opposite direction. Now I need a larger span to put this in to get the rest of that curve out. So having this handy flatbed truck here,
if you can get a look down this thing,
see the apex is right here. So if you come out here and pull down, you kind of want to take most of the bow out of it. But it's going to do most of its bending right at your fulcrum. There, boys and girls. Still go about right here. Not too far. Maybe not. Pretty good. Alright. Leave it alone.
Well, each piece has been cleaned and dried and packed with a good slathering of grease. And now, the book says, you run down this big old screw here until the end. It won't go no further. And then you back it off 1/4 to 1/2 turn. So that's where the rod stops. If I go back 1/4, I will find a cotter pin hole. And I will install, per the instructions, a new cotter pin. Mr. Cotter! I think needle nose pliers will do. Happen to have some right here on the Leatherman. I like it like that.
Next, we shall scrape away all this crud from the gearbox. Back off the jam nut. I ain't got a socket that big. I ain't got a screwdriver that big neither. But what I got is this here file. Now, there is a specification for this. And that specification calls for using a scale on the steering wheel so that you can preload this bearing. I can't even move that screw. So what you're doing is the end play of the steering shaft. The shaft that the steering wheel is connected to, not the sector shaft, which we will get to in a little bit. Well, not a little bit, after there's, well, maybe in a little bit.
it was pretty much where it needed to be. So you are going to put a little bit of bearing preload on there. And it's what I'm going to do is just like a wheel bearing just about. So we are getting a wee bit more out of that cabin. And then go see if there's too much resistance on the steering wheel. So all in all, that thing was pretty much right where it needed to be. I guess we've tightened it up just a smidgen. About right there. Watch and make sure it doesn't move when the jam nut gets jammed. Gotta be tight. So the sector shaft is the one your pitman arm connects to. Get through the grease with the wrench. Was yard down on pretty good. So, since the center position receives the most wear, you can tighten these up to where they take the play out in the center position. And then when you turn the wheel, once you get past the center, it locks up on you. Because the center is worn out, but beyond the center, it is not worn out. So you take up too much clearance, and then it jams on you when you get this wheel turned. I'm going to do this like the wheel bearing again. I'm not going to feel the steering wheel. If you snug that, you're going to have problems. So I'm going to find out where it snugs, and I'm going to back it off probably an eighth of a turn. Then we'll find out what happens when we get the wheels on it. Next! Well now. Hey, good thing that's not bursting anymore. That worked wonderfully to get the bulk of it out without bending it the opposite direction. That worked wonderfully. So, what I'm going to do, maybe I won't. Depends on this. How well I can tip the press over. So I guess I won't do that. I'll have to do it another way. Same way I straightened my T-post. My fulcrum. My apex. Where's my apex? Straightened it out so nice, I lost track. I'd hate to monkey with it anymore. But I really want to. I don't know. Just leave it. Back. That's brilliant. That's why you shouldn't monkey with it. Next, we shall scrape away all this crud. You can tighten these up to where, if I can get that screwdriver in here, you can tighten these up to where they, ow! You can tighten these up to where they take the play out in the center position.
Where did I put my paint pen? I just had it.